create your own end screens for YouTube using Adobe Express. Stick around. Hello everyone and welcome to the channel. My name is Claudio. So glad that you're here. If you are a first time visitor, thank you so much for stopping by and checking out this video. If you are a returning guest, thank you so much as well. If you're just getting started with YouTube or have been doing it for a while and want to create your own graphics like these end screens right here, today I'm walking you through how to do that with Adobe Express. So let's go ahead and dive right in. To get started creating your end screens, you'll start by clicking on the plus sign and you'll want to choose a custom size graphic. And here you'll search for social post and head over to the YouTube thumbnail. Now it is 1280 by 720, which will work fine when you're editing your videos. But if you want, you can go and create custom size, which is a 1920 by 1080. So I'll go ahead and do that. 1920 by 1080. Even if you shoot in 4K, you'll be able to resize this because you'll download as a PNG. So it'll retain its quality. So let's go ahead and choose next so we can head on over to our sandbox. And one of the things that I've done to help me with creating these end screens is taking actually a screenshot of one of my videos. So I'll go ahead and upload that screenshot so you can see what I'm talking about. Just in case you need a little bit of help with sizing up the different icons or attributes within the end screen. So let's go ahead and add that. So this right here was just a screenshot I took of my end screen and I'll just go ahead and resize this. Now I shoot my videos in 4K, but when I upload them, I actually crop them to 1920 by 960 because this it just fits better when you're viewing on a phone, but it doesn't really matter. It's all up to you. So I'll go ahead and start right here. And what I'll do is go ahead and create some shapes that will fit on the rectangle option here. And then over here, I'll type in circles. We'll add a circle and do the same thing. So we've got the circle, which is going to work for our subscribe little button. So add the circle there. And what I'll do here is I will size this up so it is about the same size. And again, this may be close to the original size, which you can in YouTube when you are adding these elements into your video and the end screen, you can size them up bigger. So I would actually go ahead and start small and then you could always increase those elements. This is just a place kind of to set up your subscribe button. It's just kind of like a holder if you would kind of use that as the terminology. And it doesn't really matter the color, but you can go ahead and make it, you know, stand out. I'll just use something like this blue just so I know that it's there. And then we'll go ahead and do the same here for the rectangle. I'll go ahead and size that up. And the nice thing about using the shapes is you can actually size the box like that. And as I mentioned, I'll just make it just a tad bit smaller because the actual element I can resize when I'm editing in YouTube. So we'll go ahead and leave that there. And if I want to have kind of this little box when I edit in post, either if you're using something like Premiere Pro or Rush, you can add these types of elements. So I'll go ahead and add a shape like that. I'll go ahead and type in, or actually, let's go ahead and remove that. Let's see. And let's do this. I'll just hit enter. And then I'll have this box right here. And I'll just resize this. And what I will do is do a little rotation, make it just a bit bigger. It doesn't matter if that stuff bleeds off to the side because all of that will not show up when you download. And what I'll do here is I'll go ahead with that nice blue color. And what I'll do is duplicate this. And then this one, you know, I'm just using my own brand. And actually, let's do this. I'll go with a white. And then this one here, I'll do that. You know, I'm using my brand color. So if you have your own brand colors, definitely recommend using that for your end screens. And I'll duplicate this one more time and make this black. And you might be saying, hey, what happened to this rectangles? Well, I will just come over here to the layers, drag it to the top, and then drag this one to the top. And what I'll do is delete this because I don't want that to show up. And just so you know that this spot right here is going to be clear when you download, because you'll want to download a transparent PNG. But something that I do just for best practice is I'll convert this to a gray, so I know that that's an area that I won't be needing to add anything, because that's where my video will be shown through. And the next thing I'll do is add some text here and say more videos. And we'll size that up so it will fit right above that box up there at the top. So you can add that. Just kind of give yourself some more, I would say, options here. So we'll go ahead and change this color to white, and you can really customize the look of this. If you want to go a bit fancy, let's choose like this right here. So you can really get creative in the style of your font. I'll go ahead and change this one now. Make sure it lines up. And then right here, since this is going to be a subscribe button, I'll add a subscribe right there. And pretty much this is ready to go. This spot right here, where I'm clicking this gray, there are no objects or elements here. It's basically just your background color. So when you choose to download as PNG, when I say transparent, this will be transparent, and the rest over here will be visible. For demonstration purposes, I'll show you what this will look like in the video. I'll go ahead and add it into my video so you can see. I just have a video playing in the background. As you can see, this is what it will look like when you add this end screen towards the bottom. And that's basically when you're giving your call out, subscribe to my channel, giving some questions or something like that. Just basically however you end your video, you'll want to use this as part of your end screen. And now you know how to create your own custom end screens for your YouTube channel using Adobe Express. If you have any comments or questions about this channel, please do drop it in the comment section below. Don't forget, like, subscribe, click the bell to be notified for future videos, and don't forget to share this video with your friends. Thank you so much for stopping by and checking out this video. And as always, be good to one another. Peace.